Hello! Hey, 안녕하세요!
Hi, hello, 안녕! I'm Intan Armidawati. Just call me Nida. My registration number is 25DSK20F2001 from DSK1A. Nice to know you, everyone!
Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. My name is Nafara Shakilah binti Mansur and my matric number is 25DSK20F2014. And today, me and my friend Anida would like to talk about benefits of being a K-pop enthusiast.
So, today, I will start our presentation with definition of K-pop. What is K-pop? I want to let everyone know that K-pop is a short form from Korean pop, which is a genre originally from South Korea. K-pop was influenced by styles and genre from all around the world, such as pop, hip-hop, dance, and more. The earliest K-pop boy band is Seo Taiji that debuted in 1992. 2 years later, a new K-pop boy group named H.O.T. debuted in 1969 as K-pop grew into a subculture that amazed animals, fandoms, and young adults. After a slump in early K-pop from 2003, TVXQ and BoA started the new generation of K-pop idols that broke the music genre into neighboring Japanese market. They also continue to popularize K-pop internationally today and gain a widespread global audience.
First, being a K-pop enthusiast can help your mind to relax. K-pop music can help you to relax as it makes your brain produce dopamine. Why? Because most of K-pop songs are very soothing and it is very suitable for students like us. In fact, there are many K-pop fans who claim that listening to K-pop helps them to go through painful and difficult times. Other than that, K-pop helps you to be more positive in life. In this modern era, many people are busy with their gadget. They also like to comment or even judge other people's posts on social media. Instead of judging each other on the social media, K-pop may be a solution to calm yourself down. Because by watching K-pop shows can increase your happiness and forget about what happens on the social media.
I will talk about the next advantages being a K-pop enthusiast. We, as a K-pop fans, admit that we can learn new language by listening to K-pop. Normally, you don't even notice that you will learn some Korean words. At least, oppa, saranghae, annyeonghaseyo, and more. We also can't deny the fact that even the K-pop haters know Korean words. Am I right? In addition, even some people will really take their time to learn Korean, which is really great. Not to be proud, but that some people, one of them is me. I started learning Korean since I was 13 years old. I never took a Korean classes before. Just self-taught, bought books, and learned from songs, dramas, and Korean variety shows. Now, I can read and write in Hangul, but not really confident to talk Korean in public. I don't even know why. I don't even know what's wrong with myself. So today, I'm going to teach all of you some Korean words. Ta-dang! The first one is oppa. Oppa for young girl called alderman. Hyung for young guy called alderman. Nuna for young guy called older woman. And oni for young girl called older woman. Basically, it's just oppa for bros. Oppa and hyung means bros. Oni and nuna means sister. But in Korean, they didn't use the same words for boy and girl. Korean is a little bit complicated, but it's so fun to learn new language. That is the fourth advantage being a K-pop enthusiast. Learn new language. If you're a fan of NCT, a K-pop boy band from SM Entertainment that have 23 members from Korea, Thailand, China, Japan, Chicago, Canada. Soon? Maybe from Malaysia? We don't know. Because NCT concept is as long as you are talented, you can debut as their group members. So you better be their fans now before they have 50 members. Listen to me. Since they have so many members from many countries, fans tend to learn new language every day. One of their group members, Shitaponi Chai Ponku, or his stage name is Tan. He's from Thai, but he can speak 5 languages. And now, I'm trying to learn Japanese because in NCT, I bias this man. This man right here, Gia Nakamoto Yuta, one day I will watch your Japanese video without subtitle. I'm still trying my best to learn Japanese because of you. And for all of you who watch our videos, I suggest all of you to listen their B-side track from latest album, Reasonings Part 2. That song title is From Home. That song used 4 languages in one song, which is really amazing. Please listen to that song, okay?
Every benefit must have its disadvantage. Being a K-pop fan is not easy. We can't really manage our money properly. Why? Because we as K-pop fans have some hobbies that we collect unnecessary things, such as albums, photocards, and many more. For example, this is my album, my favorite boy band album. And let me show you how it looks like. It's just a photo book. Yeah, this is called photo book. And with your handsome face in it. And some photo cards, a bunch of photo cards. And this CD is also. And this costs at 90 ringgit Malaysia. Yeah, my bank account is hurt right now. So Nida, how about you?
Yes, Farah, I really agree with you. 200% agree with you. I just waste my money only for this, and I have so many photo cards. I don't know how much all of this costs. I don't remember, as long as I'm happy. And yeah, I think it's fine. What did I do with all of this? Only for this handsome card. I put it at the back of my phone. And the rest of this, I keep it in the book like this and close it and keep the book wisely. All my boyfriends in here, okay? So I keep it wisely.
Many people still can't really get how fun and interesting K-pop is. They just ignore the existence of K-pop just because they don't understand the language. Why don't people respect the existence of K-pop? People should open their minds so that they can get more knowledge that actually K-pop is not that bad.
So my advice for today for K-pop fans, for a K-pop fan, a K-pop girl, don't force people to listen K-pop. Some will eventually like it but hate it when someone really push them to like K-pop. The next advice for K-popers, listen as many as you can. You will find so many amazing songs that bury under popular songs. You should listen to soloists, to hip-hop, to sub-unit, mixtape, and everything. Not because they are Korean, it's because the singer also a K-pop idol. You should give them a chance. Okay, my advice for a newbie K-popper, K-popper-to-be, and for someone who will get into a K-pop world, join the family, the K-pop family. Okay, don't force yourself to like or dislike a certain group by just reading or listen to others' opinion about that group. Okay, in terms of variety, find a show that enjoy regardlessly of what your idols appear in them. And you will find more and more interesting groups by this way. Try this method, okay? My last advice to a newbie K-popper, don't be too shocked if you watch a live performance and there is a bunch of fans screaming the names of the name of each member in one group. If NCT have 23 members, they will shout all the 23's name. Don't be shocked, okay? Calm down. One is the most common thing if you watch K-pop live performance is the hordes of fans reciting chants in the background alongside the performer in rhythmic center point to the song itself. These fan chants are created and spread throughout the fan base for a particular band. So fans in live studio audience or in concert can shout to them during the musical intros or choruses to show a unity and a unity support to the idols.
I got a question. The question is, what is the most K-pop songs are about? Okay, from my opinion, most of K-pop songs are about motivation, such as how important is your family, your friends in your life, how you should love yourself, and last but not least is, it's about our mental health. That's why I have told you guys that K-pop songs are very suitable or very common for students like us.
See you guys next time. Big hug. Yeah!